series called Cooking to Cope. I am Debbie Besson. I'm the Director of Clinical Nutrition at Whole Eating Health, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to use simple ingredients to prepare healthy meals. And now more than ever, it's very important to think of nutrition to boost your immune system. Today, I'm going to show you how easy it is to make your own fermented pickles. Fermented pickles have lots of probiotics. Probiotics are good for your immune system.
I picked up this mason jar from my local supermarket. I washed it with soap and water and then microwaved it for 30 seconds to sanitize. To sanitize the lid, I boiled it for about 1 to 2 minutes. I'm going to start with the herbs and spices. I'm going to put them on the bottom of the mason jar. I'm going to start with the fresh dill, handful of fresh dill. Then I'm going to put 2 dried bay leaves, 2 crushed garlic cloves. The cucumbers I bought organic, and I also made sure to buy them unwaxed. The wax is going to prevent the fermentation process. So I stuffed the mason jar with cucumbers, topped it off with a handful of peppercorns, and then I add the salted water. The ratio for the water and salt is 1.5 teaspoons of fine sea salt per cup of water. Make sure that you buy uniodized fine sea salt. The iodine in iodized table salt will also prevent the fermentation process. I fill it up to the top and I cut some cucumbers and kind of used it as a weight to keep the whole cucumbers under the water the whole fermentation time.
The pickles are ready to ferment. Store them in the basement or some other dry area. Check on them nightly. Give it a little burp or let some air out, and I'll see you in about 5 to 7 days. Hi, so it's been 6 days and I have a perfectly fermented jar of pickles. How did I know it was gonna be 6 days? I didn't. I checked it every night, I tasted it, and once it was sour enough, I brought it up and I put it in the refrigerator. Besides cucumbers, you can ferment any vegetable like I did here. In this jar are fermented radishes. And there you have it, a fun, inexpensive, and easy way to get your probiotics. Thanks for tuning in to Cooking to Cope. I hope to see you soon.